time for Art 101. Art 101 with Mr. Burger. Hello, friends. Welcome back to another installment of Art 101 with me, Mr. Burger, a professional artist and educator attempting to bring you the best in art historical content.
Take a bath, hippie!
I always appreciate likes, shares, subscribes, comments, so please interact with the video.
It's a voice from your past.
Probably one of the most iconic presidents in the history of the United States is Teddy Roosevelt. And there is a story of Teddy Roosevelt and a bear. And I think it's only fitting that I tell you a little bit about the story of how Teddy Roosevelt made the teddy bear a reality.
Now, when it comes to the teddy bear, they would create a series of dancing bears that began production between 1897 and 1899.
Louie, check the Junior Woodchuck Guidebook!
Now that's a good call, keeping track of the timeline on this, because in 1902 they would design Bear 55PB, which is the first soft toy with movable joints, and would become known as the first teddy bear. By 1903, a large shipment of these toys was sent to New York, and that resulted in orders of over 3,000 bears to be brought back. Although they began with elephants being the hot commodity, Bear 55PB became their best seller. Starting in 1906, the bear became known as the Teddy Bear, which was named after American President Theodore Roosevelt.
Some men are born great. Others have greatness thrust upon them.
You know, what do I know? I color for a living, but I know a little something about the connection between Teddy Roosevelt and the Teddy Bear. As the story goes, President Roosevelt was on a hunting trip in Mississippi, and they were having a rather hard time finding a bear for him to shoot. After a long day trying to hunt a bear down, he ends up going back to camp. And in the meantime, one of the hunting guide's dogs had sniffed out an old bear. Now the dogs put up a pretty good fight with this old bear. As a matter of fact, one of them may have even been killed by the bear. But at any rate, the scout took the butt of his gun and smashed the bear in the head, and then tied a rope around its neck, tethering the bear to a tree. The other scouts went and retrieved President Roosevelt to go be able to kill this bear. Upon arrival, the president was kind of dismayed by the whole thing, and he thought it would be unsportsmanlike to shoot a bear that was tied to a tree. Now, there are some accounts that somebody in the party ended up killing the bear anyway, but the story of Roosevelt finding it unsportsmanlike to kill a bear tethered to a tree got out, and there was an editorial cartoonist that made a rendering of this story, only depicting it as a baby bear and not an old, gnarled up bear. And the humanitarian aspect of Roosevelt grew in popularity, and it wasn't long until others wanted to exploit the story for their own personal gains.
You're being cynical, Robin. To err is human, to forgive, divine.
In terms of the teddy bear, there are two completely different stories of the origin. So the question is,
are you interested in the real story or just the patriotic crap they want you to believe?
Now, it is claimed that there was a toy maker in New York that had first made the teddy bears to sell into his candy store. According to lore, they did get permission from Roosevelt, but he really didn't care because he thought it was a silly idea anyway. The bears became so popular that they would found Ideal Toy Company. Now remember, this hunting expedition took place in 1902. The bears from Ideal were released in 1903. And by that point, the Stife Company had already been making teddy bears for 3 years. But because the origin of the teddy bear is German and not American, we have buried the true history of our teddy bear to be an American story and not an international story. Even though, historically, it definitely is.
Y'all don't have a f***ing clue. Facebook shit, the internet, your shit isn't real.
At the time that Marguerite Stife and her company was making the initial bear concept, This was a time when bears were seen as vicious predators, not cuddly little cute things. But in our world today, it's kind of different. We have Winnie the Pooh and Paddington, the Cubs, Corduroy, Yogi.
The world would be better off if I was only as smart as the average bear.
Bears, 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 bears!
Man, that's a cute story.
Wait, man, why are you always such a dork, man? What are you talking about?
Check you later. Check you later. Hey, man.